वेलकम बैक चिल्ड्रन। वी हैव ऑलरेडी कवर्ड अप ग्रेविटेशन इन द लास्ट लेक्चर। वी हैव डन अ फ्यू न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑल्सो। सो टुडे वी वुड बी स्टार्टिंग अ न्यू टॉपिक और अ न्यू चैप्टर, एंड द चैप्टर इज वर्क एंड एनर्जी। Now, before we move on to this chapter, we need to know what is work. What is work? Work is a very common term that we use. Everyone uses. Bhai hum kaam kar rahe hain, so we are doing some work. But what exactly is work in the language of physics? Physics mein hum isko kaise define karenge? Work. To understand the concept of work, let us take a few examples. The first example, let us say, moving a or pushing a table, let us say, pushing a table on the floor. To move it from one position or one place to another. If the table is moving, we say that we have done some work. जो हमने फोर्स लगाया उस टेबल को मूव करा सका और हम बोलेंगे कि वर्क डन हुआ है. सेकेंड, लेट अस टेक पुशिंग ए ट्रॉली. Pushing a trolley by applying force, and when we are applying force, it would move by certain distance. To move it by a certain distance. Here also we are applying some force. We are pushing the trolley, and by pushing, what is happening to the trolley? The trolley is moving by some distance, and if the trolley is moving by some distance, we say that we have done some work. Or then let us take a third example, lifting a box. Lifting a box to some height. Lifting a box to some height by applying force. So if you look at all these three conditions, pushing a table, pushing a trolley, or lifting a box, the first and the foremost condition is we need to apply a force. Here we are pushing the table, here we are pushing the trolley. Lifting a box means we are pulling the box. So the first condition to say that we have done some work is application of force. So, from these examples, we can come to a simple conclusion. क्या होगा conclusion? Conclusion होगा कि अगर हमको work करना है, the work is done if the first condition. What would be the first condition? If there is a force applied on the body, there is an application of force. एप्लीकेशन ऑफ फोर्स, मतलब हमको फोर्स चाहिए. इफ देर इज एन एप्लीकेशन ऑफ फोर्स ऑन द बॉडी देन वी से दैट वी हैव डन सम वर्क. एंड इफ द बॉडी इज नॉट मूविंग, मान लो कि बॉडी मूव नहीं कर रहा है, आपने फोर्स तो लगाया है. एंड इफ दिस फोर्स इज नॉट एबल टू कॉज एनी डिस्प्लेसमेंट देन वॉट विल बी से, वी विल से वर्क डन इज इक्वल टू जीरो, देर इज नो वर्क डन. सो द सेकेंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कंडीशन इज देर हैज टू बी displacement in the body. The second condition is, what is the second condition? The second condition is the body must get displaced. The body must get displaced. So if we take S as the displacement, so force is one condition and S is the second condition. Force or displacement दोनों अगर होंगे तो हम बोलेंगे कि हमारा जो force है it has done some work. So work के लिए condition क्या है? It means force apply किया और object जो है वो displace हुआ. So let us define work now. The definition of work would be, work is said to be done. The definition would be, work is said to be done if a force applied on the body, if a force applied on the body causes some displacement, later on in the chapter we would talk about displacement ki kaun sa direction mein ho raha hai displacement. Kya hamara force jis direction mein hai us direction mein displacement ho raha hai, ya jis direction mein humne force lagaya uske opposite direction mein displacement. There are different conditions which we will talk about in the other lectures. So displacement is a condition, is an important condition. Force is the second condition. Force is the first condition and displacement is the second condition. So work done must be dependent on force. Ke upar dependent hona chahiye. So work done must be dependent on force F. And the second important factor, work done must be dependent on displacement S. More is the force, more would be the displacement. So we can say work done is mathematically, agar hum likhne ki koshish kare, we would write work done is directly proportional to force F. And work done is directly proportional to displacement S. So if you combine these two, what do we get? We would get work done is proportional to, work done is proportional to force multiply displacement, क्योंकि force के साथ भी proportional हो रहा है और displacement के साथ भी proportional हो रहा है. तो force ज्यादा तो वर्क डन भी ज्यादा, डिस्प्लेसमेंट ज्यादा तो वर्क डन भी ज्यादा. सो फोर्स इज मोर, वर्क डन इज मोर, डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज मोर, वर्क डन इज मोर. सो वी राइट डब्ल्यू प्रोपोर्शनल टू एफ एस. इफ यू रिमूव द प्रोपोर्शनलिटी साइन, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर कि अगर आप यह प्रोपोर्शनैलिटी साइन हटाते हो देन वी राइट कॉन्स्टेंट मल्टीप्लाई एफ एस एंड कॉन्स्टेंट वी टेक द वैल्यू एज वन हियर सो वी गेट फाइनली वर्क इज इक्वल टू वर्क डन इज इक्वल टू डब्ल्यू एंड दिस इज इक्वल टू फोर्स इंटू डिस्प्लेसमेंट. So from here we get a mathematical definition of work done. What is the mathematical definition of work done? Mathematically work done can be defined as work done is defined as the product of force applied and the displacement caused. So agar aap isko diagrammatically dekhoge to this is the body and we have applied a force. We have applied a force on the body. Let us say this is the force F and this body is getting displaced by, let us say, this is the displacement. The body moves here. If the body has moved by certain displacement, so this is the displacement S, then we say work is equal to F into S. The product of force and displacement is equal to work done. Now from this formula also you can see if displacement s is equal to zero then work done is also equal to zero. ये बहुत बार ऐसा होता है कि आपने किसी बड़े से huge rock को push किया. You have pushed a huge rock and the rock is not moving at all. And if the rock is not moving, then we say that the work done is zero. So work done is equal to zero when displacement is equal to zero. Force is not zero. You are applying some force on the body. And if the force applied is not able to cause any displacement, then we say that work done is zero. And when is force equal to zero? Now let us say that you have applied a force. Now this is very important. Please try to understand this concept. If a force applied causes displacement such that the body is moving with a constant velocity, ऐसे भी तो हो सकता है कि आपने फोर्स अप्लाई किया, यू हैव पुश्ड अ बॉडी और यू हैव पुल्ड अ बॉडी. आपने बॉडी को पुल किया या पुश किया, पुश करने के बाद अगर वो ऑब्जेक्ट एक ही वेलोसिटी से मूव कर रहा है, इफ द बॉडी इज मूविंग विद अ कांस्टेंट वेलोसिटी, इफ यू रिमेंबर द चैप्टर फोर्स एंड लॉज ऑफ मोशन, इफ अ बॉडी इज मूविंग विद अ कांस्टेंट वेलोसिटी मींस एक्सेलरेशन इज इक्वल टू जीरो. इसका मतलब एक्सेलरेशन जीरो होगा. अगर एक्सेलरेशन जीरो होगा तो अगर मैं इस कंडीशन को अप्लाई करता हूं देन फोर्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सो इस कंडीशन में क्या हो रहा है, डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज नॉट जीरो. फ्रॉम हियर वी आर गेटिंग अ कंडीशन, डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो बट फोर्स इज इक्वल टू जीरो. तो इस कंडीशन में भी हम बोलेंगे कि वर्क डन जीरो है. व्हाई? बिकॉज इफ आई अप्लाई न्यूटन्स सेकंड लॉ एफ इज इक्वल टू एम इनटू ए, एक्सेलरेशन जीरो होते ही फोर्स जीरो हो गया, और फोर्स जीरो होते ही वर्क डन जीरो हो गया. सो दिस टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस कैन बी वेरी ट्रिकी. गिव एन एग्जांपल वेयर ए फोर्स अप्लाइड is equal to zero but the displacement is not equal to zero. So this would be the condition where the force is equal to zero and displacement is not equal to zero. Now we have got a formula W is equal to F into S. Let us try to come back to this formula again. W is equal to F into S. What is the SI unit of force? SI unit of force is Newton. SI unit of force is Newton, and displacement is meter. So what would be the SI unit of work then? SI unit of work done would be work is Newton. Okay, Newton, we need to write it in small letters, is Newton multiply meter, because formula is W is equal to F into S. Force ka unit kya hai? Force ka unit Newton hai, aur displacement ka unit meter. So Newton meter is also called joule. SI unit of work is joule. So how to define 1 joule? 1 joule would be equal to 1 joule of work would be equal to 1 newton into 1 meter. So from here we can define work of 1 joule. If a force of 1 newton, look at the mathematical definition, if a force of 1 newton displaces a body by 1 meter, then work done is said to be 1 joule. So definition is how to define 1 joule. So let us define 1 joule. 1 joule of work. 1 joule of work. So definition is, if a force of 1 newton causes a displacement of 1 meter when applied on a body, then work done is said to be 1 joule. 1 joule is the SI unit of work. So 1 joule is equal to 1 newton into 1 meter. In most of the book it is written Nm. Nm means joule. It's nothing but joule. Let us come to the CGS unit of work. This comes in the competitive exams. What is the CGS unit of work? CGS unit of work is erg, and let us try to find out the relation between erg and joule. So what is 1 newton? Newton is the SI unit of force. What is the CGS unit of force? So to define erg, let us try to understand first. 1 joule is equal to 1 newton into 1 meter. So this 1 newton can be written as 10 power of 5 dyne. Dyne is the CGS unit of force. CGS unit of force. And 1 newton is equal to 10 power of 5 dynes. You have to remember this. You can even calculate how it has come, 1 10 power of 5 dynes. How does it come? Do you want me to see? You see this relationship? I am solving it now. 1 newton would be equal to force, mass into acceleration, 1 kg into 1 meter per second square. This is the definition of 1 newton. So this 1 kg can be written as 1000 gram into 1 meter can be written as 100 centimeter per second square. So this becomes 10 power of 5 gram centimeter per second square. And this is nothing but dyne. So 1 newton is equal to 10 power of 5 dyne. So now let us come back to this topic. 1 joule, we are converting 1 joule of work into its CGS system. So 1 joule is equal to 1 newton into 1 meter. 1 newton is nothing but 10 power of 5 dyne into 1 meter can be written as 100 centimeter. And this becomes 10 power of 5 into 100 dyne centimeter. And dyne centimeter is called as erg. And this becomes 10 power of 7 ergs. So it is 1 joule. Remember this value. 1 joule is equal to 10 power of 7 erg. This is the conversion of the unit of SI unit of work into its CGS unit. So 1 joule is the SI unit, erg is the CGS unit of work. Okay, so W is equal to F into S. Now from this formula, please try to understand displacement. Displacement jo hai, if you remember chapter number 1, we talked about distance and displacement. Distance can never be zero, distance can never be negative. But ye jo displacement hai, displacement can be positive, it can be negative, it can be zero. So from these three simple concepts, we can have three different types of work. Now look at this formula, W is equal to F into S again. W is equal to F into S can be positive, it can be negative, even it can be zero. Depends on the direction of this displacement. So displacement ke upar sara kuch depend karta hai ki agar displacement positive hua to work done positive bolenge. Agar displacement negative hua, displacement negative matlab agar hum baat kare frictional force, work done by frictional force, the direction in which a body is moving is always equal to the direction of frictional force. So us case mein force ek side mein, displacement ek aur side mein, opposite direction mein ja rahe. So if the force and displacement are exactly opposite in direction, then work done would be negative because displacement is in the opposite direction. Work force and displacement are in the same direction. When you are pushing a box, the box is moving in the same direction as the force applied. तो हम बोलेंगे कि फोर्स जो है वो सेम डायरेक्शन में डिस्प्लेसमेंट का, तो वर्क डन वुड बी पॉजिटिव. कैन वर्क डन बी जीरो? वी हैव ऑलरेडी टॉक्ड अबाउट अर्लियर आल्सो कि वर्क डन वुड बी जीरो व्हेन द बॉडी इज नॉट एट ऑल मूविंग. कैन देयर बी अदर कंडीशंस फॉर वर्क डन टू बी जीरो? यस, ऑफ कोर्स वी हैव गॉट डिफरेंट कंडीशंस फॉर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ वर्क. So in today's lecture, what we have talked is we have talked about the concept of work, the definition of work, and we also tried to define 1 joule of work. We converted 1 joule of work into erg. Next class we would be continuing with, or in the next lecture we would be dealing with the types of work. We would be also talking about what is the work done when the force is acting at a certain angle to the body. Okay, now keep watching the videos, keep subscribing, like the videos. Thank you very much.